at the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. I'm Vern Lundquist here with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wilson. What do you think, Bill? There's a terrific matchup at the small forward position. Manny is undoubtedly one of the best small forwards in the nation. He's quite a shot blocker for a small forward, and that just adds to his versatility. It's just one of those things he can do to help you win.
Welcome back, guys, to another episode.
He's got tremendous knobs, and I'm sure we'll be able to see him.
2K8, Georgetown Boys Dynasty. It's the second video I'm making. You guys checked out the first one. It was nothing to write home about, as I got completely blown away and destroyed by Old Dominion. It was close in the first half. I ended up losing by 40. And it's pretty sad because Georgetown's pretty good. And I lost to a mid-major. But most of that gets credited to the fact that I haven't played this game in so long. I'm just now getting back into it.
Number four.
I got to
with the shot.
2K19, 2018.
Miss right there.
College rosters.
There wasn't a defender in sight.
So that inspired me to get back into it.
But
you know, we don't play a game for so long over the years.
Out left.
The controls have changed so much.
Manny.
The dribbling is different. The shooting is similar, but not exactly. The shot stick, the dribble stick, all that stuff is so different. And it takes some time to get back adjusted to it. But check it out. It's going to be a full gameplay. I'm going straight through. No edit. Going straight through. Check it out. Hopefully we'll get a nice W here. Against Fairfield, who's definitely not a very, very big school, and has to be able to manhandle them, but we'll see what happens.
Number 15.
Check it out. Enjoy the video.
Number 3.
I'll be in and out.
Number 13.
So I'll catch you in a little bit.
The rebound. And it's still a tie game. Takes it up. Pulled in by number 3. Feeds it. Far side. McClung catches it. Far side. Number 15. To the rim. Misses it. Number 13 has picked up his first foul of the game. Shooting. Knocks down the first one. He gets them both. Number 13 inbounds the ball. Passes, top of the key. Number 4. Gets it. Baseline. The shot was short by number 14. Still a double-digit game. From long range, it was hit by LeBlanc. And they now go up by 5. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy Wilson, who has some info for us.
Just before the game, I talked with Coach Thompson III. This is such a potent offensive team that he said they sometimes fall into the trap of trying to simply outscore teams instead of defending effectively. Today, he'd like to see a well-balanced effort instead of an offensive overload, guys.
Thanks, Tracy. One-on-one. Swings it far side. Number 15. Poked loose. But it's recovered by Georgetown. That last rebound is drained by LeBlanc. Terrific pass there. I love the way this fella dishes it out, Burn. Passes it to the wing. Number 13. Has it. Top of the key. Dishes. Right wing. Cruz can't put an end to the run. The Hoyas can push their lead to double digits.
Well, you can't afford to spot the other team any more points, Vern. They're in danger of letting this game be over before the second half.
The Stags take their first time out of the game.
So we're at the 11:50 mark in the first half. Just about halfway through, the first half. And so far, we're doing what we're supposed to do. It's 10-0. We're completely dominating them. We're swinging the ball around, and we get open shots. Knocked down a couple threes so far, and we made Fairmont call a quick timeout here to regroup. Hopefully, we can keep it up and go into the half with a huge lead. So, play some of our younger guys in the second half.
Number 13 inbounds the ball. Alvarez takes the shot. Can't get the three-pointer to fall. The Hoyas looking to continue their run.
Might have rushed that one just a little bit. There was plenty of time on the shot clock, but he got a little over-anxious.
Number 15. Backs in. Hits the layup. They now have a dozen unanswered points.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in, Vern. Minimum.
Great pass. Shoots it. 20-footer was off by number 4. He got it up there, but it just wouldn't fall.
With a little more touch, it might have.
Gets it to go, and he's got a chance to add one more.
Terrific work to absorb the contact, hang in the air, and hit the shot. Pretty, Vern.
No good, and they don't get the three-point play. Alvarez dishes to the right side. Number 4, the crossover. Beats it to the top of the key. Alvarez skips it to the right wing. Cruz, good from downtown. And they're now behind by 11. About 10 and a half minutes left in the half.
By yourself.
The spin move.
Ball.
Number 15 goes up, hits the layup after the pump fake freezes the D. He's got 6.
Coach Hill saw something out there he didn't like it, and he called for a timeout. He wants to make sure that everyone is working together out there.
Number 13 inbounds the ball. Crew gets it. Right wing. Pass to the free throw line. Stolen away by number 3.
I'd love to see that. He's lurking around and pounced. Such a defer.
The Hoyas turn this one over out of bounds. Alvarez catches it, right wing. Crew passes to the stripe, baseline, goes up. Nice job on the assist by number 14. But they're still behind. Georgetown with the ball. They're on a 16-5 run. Bounces it to the free throw line. McClung. Got it. They're up 19-5. Alvarez for 3. Manning yanks it down inside. Just over 9 minutes left in the half.
It's still early, Vern, but they can't take any more time to get this thing going. It hasn't been pretty for them so far.
Launches it. It was drained by McClung. He's shooting 100% from deep. Dumps it inside. Alvarez puts it up. Can't return the favor with his own 3.
Terrific job clearing some space under the glass. Physicality prevailing.
Manning catches it. Right wing. Last shot missed from 3-point range. The steal by Manning. The D was really waiting for him there.
That's how you do it. Keep the heat on. Wait for the misstep and then capitalize.
McClung fires the 3. Crew pulls it down.
They've got to learn to be patient on offense. Good shots will come if you don't rush them.
Takes it up. The finger roll was laid in by number 14. And they're now behind by 15. Right around 8 minutes left in the half. Stolen by Fairfield. Number 4 picks it up. McClung from deep. Reeled in by Cruz. They're still up 15. Skip pass to the stripe. Cruz from deep. It drops. He's 2 for 2 from downtown. Number 3 brings it up the floor. LeBlanc. McClung beats it to the top of the key. Unloads from 10 feet. Hits it. They increase their lead to 14.
They're set up in Nineveh.
Fairfield calls timeout. Teams are making a few lineup changes. Number 30 inbounds the ball. Passes to the wing. Alvarez. Morning gets the board inside. About 6.5 minutes left in the half.
Alvarez is having a hard time getting his shot to go, Vern. You just hope it doesn't wreck his confidence, but it's hard to see how it would.
Number 4 hands it off. Goes up. Good job on the layup by Alvarez. He's got 2.
Stay with it, stay with it.
Swings it to the right wing. Number 3 catches it. Top of the key. Didn't fall by number 5. But they're still out in front by 12. Feeds down low. Morning inbounds the ball. Number 3 brings it up court. Morning.
By yourself.
Number 5 pulls the trigger. Gets the 3-pointer to go. By 13. Beats it to the elbow. Releases from 16 feet. Hit the left iron but missed by number 15.
Oh, not real good shot selection, Vern. They've got to exercise a little patience and move the ball around.
Manning. Nice pass. Kicks it out to the outside. Number 5 tosses it up. Off the mark with the 3-ball. Still a 13-point lead. Behind the arc. Manning grabs the rock.
He'll want another shot with that much space. He knows he can make it.
Pass, top of the key. Puts it up. The offensive rebound by number 20. Number 13 inbounds the ball. Fairfield has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
Coach Hill is definitely aware of that problem. He told his assistants that they have to bring more defenders into the paint, even if it means leaving the perimeter open. Desperate measures here, Vern.
All right, Tracy. That last basket was buried by Alvarez.
Sweetness!
They gave him a look and paid for it. Number 5. can't connect from long range. But they're still up by 13. Catches it, right wing. Number 50 takes it up, slides in with a soft finger roll. But they're still down by 11. Under 4 minutes left in the half. Number 3 bounces it to the wing. Cross court, raises up. The three-point shot was offline by number 5. They still have an 11-point lead. Passes it to the wing. Number 13. Alvarez off the backboard and in. Georgetown takes its first timeout of the game.
Hill may have to deal with some chemistry issues after those substitutions because that gives them a pretty inexperienced lineup out there.
Number 20 inbounds the ball. Number 20 goes up, lays it right in. And they're now up by 11.
They've got their defense and it's
minute. Goes up. The layup was banked in by number 4. They're now down by 9. 2:52 left in the first half. Number 20 has it. Left wing. McClung from 20 feet out. Number 50 has it. And that's his third rebound of the contest.
The D knows he can make that shot unchecked, and he did a good job staying with him on the play.
Off target on the last shot by Cruz. Goes to the crossover. McClung dumps it off. Number 5 passes it back to the right. Once again, it's buried by number 20. They're in front, 33-22. Number 30 inbounds the ball. Dishes to the left. Number 4 releases. No good out of the corner.
You have to hit that.
Hard to imagine he could get a cleaner look. Feeds it to the left wing. Number 5 catches it. Left wing.
You have to keep your head up and eyes open at all times playing with this guy.
That's right, and you never know when or where he'll find you. Dish, left wing. Number 4. Takes a 3. Pulled in by number 30. Bounces high, but falls through. He's got 2. McClung, way up court. McClung, the crossover. Number 5 from downtown. Number 50 corrals the miss inside. Gets the bucket. They're now up by 13. Number 4 passes to the right side. Right wing. Unloads. Can't get it to fall from downtown. He got the look he wanted to there, Bill.
I wouldn't let him have too many more of those. He can light you up in a hurry.
Launches one from beyond the arc. Snatched inside by number 30.
That's just a blown assignment by the defense. You can't afford too many of those.
Number 4. Number 4 lets it go. Misses the long one. With the crossover. Dishes it to the elbow. Throws it up. The three-pointer knocked down by number 5. He's shooting 28% from three-point. Number 30 inbounds the ball. No luck. First half comes to an end. Score 40-24. What do you think of the first half, Bill?
I can't think of too much good to say about this game, so Vern, maybe you can do play-by-play and color.
Quick halftime update. We started off very hot, dominating them. We brought our second unit in, took out Mac McClung, and we made a small little run. Never got close enough for me to worry, but we did make a run. Mac McClung out. Things weren't as smooth. Here's a little halftime update. McClung's got 10 points. Jesse Bovine is leading the way. 8-10. There's really no match for him inside. He's dominating the boys and giving a lot of second opportunities.
We're ready to begin the second half. Morning. Inbounds it to start the second half. Tracy Wolfson has more on what went on at halftime. Tracy?
Well, at halftime, I talked with Coach Thompson III. He felt it wouldn't be classy to run up the score and was going to change things in a way to make sure that doesn't happen. Coach said that even though his starters had plenty of energy, he would still rotate in his bench players. He said that it wasn't a question of fatigue, but more of a method of showing different looks on offense. Guys?
Thank you, Tracy. Passes to the free throw line. Alvarez pulls the trigger on target from 16 feet. 8 points, and he's his team's leading scorer.
A little bit, trying to force the turnovers. So we're gonna try to
number
field
15
big man.
Gets it on the perimeter.
Trey Moore's out.
Number
50
grabs the offensive rebound.
The
steal by Fairfield. Again, he's making big plays on defense to help his ball club.
What cagey instincts on the defensive end.
We should easily keep maintaining this
by number four.
This, you know, 10 to 15 point gap. And then hopefully in the last few minutes of the game we could bring in some younger guys, some freshmen, and give them a look.
Morning.
They haven't really
from
gotten too many looks this season so far.
Golden by Cruz, and that's his third rebound of the contest.
When a D got lucky there, Vern, you can't expect many misses when you're that open.
But it's recovered by Alvarez. Swings it to the left wing. Yanked down inside by number 20.
Their rebounding has been terrific, Vern, and that's the main reason they're leading in this game.
Number 5 with the shot. No luck on the three-point attempt. But they still lead by 14. Number 30 has it on the free throw line. Dumps it to the inside. Lets it go. All net on the shot by number 14. Number 20 inbounds the ball. Number 5. Number 20 floats it up. Cruz pulls it in. They've still got a 12-point lead. Alvarez, lead pass to the inside. And he makes the first. The Hoyas are going to bring all their starters back out there now. Splits the free throws. Number 50, way up court. Number 3, uses the crossover. Skips it to the elbow. Takes it up. The nice reverse layup is made by Manning. by 15.
It looks like they're playing minimum.
Crew in the key, bullseye. He's shooting 50% for the game. McClung launches it. Number 50 pulls it in. The last shot lays gently in. Fairfield calls time. They're getting set to inbound the ball. Number 4 will leave the floor, and he's really been struggling so far.
That was another example of just
number
size.
14 inbounds the ball.
Can't replace
right around
size.
12
can't
minutes
teach
left
size.
In the second
Jesse
half.
Goldwyn just dominating the board, offensive and defensive, and he's really the main reason why
number 14 has it
up by
on
so much.
The elbow.
Because we're not necessarily playing very good. I'm not playing very good at all. But when you got better players in college, it makes a big difference.
Feeds far side, launches one from beyond the arc. The basket was made by McClung. 13 points, and he's the top scorer. Fairfield is really struggling. Number 30.
Alvarez can't hit the shot off the glass. That was a much quicker shot than they might have liked, but it was a pretty open look, so it's tough to fault him.
Number 3 from downtown. Crew yanks it down inside. With nobody around, he still couldn't convert.
Sometimes you can be too wide open.
Manning inbounds the ball. Manning passes it to the left. Right wing takes the shot. Good from downtown by number 3. He's 1-for-3 from deep. Under 11 minutes left in the second half. Crew raises up. Answers right back with his own 3. But they still trail by 12. Fires. Long rebound controlled by Manning. McClung takes the 3. Number 14 snatches it down.
What a good job on the defense to make him think about that shot.
Feeds it to the wing. Unloads. The lead is cut to single digits by Cruz. They got on this roll a while ago and just haven't looked back. Number 3. Crosses it over. Dishes it to the perimeter. Lob. Low block. Number 50 forgot where he was on the floor. He gets called for a 3-second violation.
They hit a big 3 from the wing, cut it down to 9, and now I really need to start focusing.
Number
50
inbounds the ball.
Hopefully we get a little run going ourselves here to expand the lead back to a comfortable range. They're making a little bit of a run here, a little bit of a move.
Alvarez swings it to the right wing. Misfire by number 15.
Again,
last attempt
making
off the
difference.
By number 30.
He's really not a strong finisher, and the defense was all over him. You just want to pass it out when that happens.
Right wing passes to the left side. LeBlanc. McClung tosses it up. They rule this one goaltender. Count the shot. The Stags are really struggling. Feeds it to the right wing. The offensive board gathered by number 13. Number 15 inbounds the ball. Manning catches it, left wing. McClung gets it. Left corner. Shoots the 3. Collected inside by McClung.
McClung didn't get that rebound by accident. He knew right where to be.
About 8.5 minutes left in the second half. Alvarez bounces it to the left side. Top of the key. Dishes to the right. Alvarez throws it up. Misses the 3-pointer.
That's another rebound for a team that's doing a great job on the boards. They've got a big edge there today.
Number three. Passes it cross court. McClung drills the long three. They're now out in front by 50. Number 13 inbounds the ball.
They're playing man-to-man here, Vern.
Number 15 hands it off. Double clutches. Nearly had a chance for a three-point play, but will go to the line for two. Knocks down the first one. The Stags will bring a few more starters back in.
Matt McClung with the three. He's been consistent today with that three ball. Overall for the season, he's been pretty inconsistent. So it's a good thing to see here. I've seen some consistency from the best player.
Gets the second to fall as well. McClung, nice little crossover. Number three. That last shot netted for three.
Something must have been
said at halftime. These guys are hitting all kinds of shots from the perimeter.
In the second half, he's been off all game.
Has it?
And he needs to be more
assertive.
We definitely need to have a stretch.
Misfired on that last three by number 14.
I don't think he'll miss many more of those looks.
Usually this is when I start bringing in the second unit to give my first unit a breather. But since we're
number
up
three,
so much,
from
I'm going to play through.
Number 15,
and
snatches
it
down inside.
In a few minutes here to close out the game.
Fairfield is really struggling. Releases. The triple was off the mark by Benning.
He didn't have a lot of room out there, and it kept him from getting comfortable on that shot.
McClung puts it up, drains it from the low block. They're ahead, 63-45.
Coach Hill saw something happen. He wants to make some adjustment. He burned his timeout to get his players' attention.
Well, it looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball. Number 14 inbounds the ball. For three. Rebounded by LeBlanc. The D wasn't too worried about that one. Gave him room to get it off.
Mainly because they prefer the long three over him driving it in.
Skips it to the wing. Number three. Uses the crossover.
This fella is a fantastic offensive player, Vern. That kind of defense just isn't going to cut it against him.
About 6.5 minutes left in the second half. Dishes to the wing. Fired short by Cruz. Fairfield has struggled with their three-point shooting. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
Coach Hill wants to see his players move more effectively without the ball so they can get better looks at the basket. He told his guys, if you get to the open spot on the floor, I know you can hit that shot. Vern?
Thanks, Tracy. A rare occurrence.
As long as you keep running your offense, the coach will forgive a few clunkers.
That last basket was buried by Alvarez. The steal.
Oh, the quick hands. Before they even knew what hit them, he made off with that one.
Number 14 from deep. Count it. They now trail by 15. McClung passes way down court. Leads him with the pass. Number 50 finishes in close. He's got 12. The Stags with some difficulties. Number 13 catches it on the low block.
A little sloppy on the release.
You're right. Just a little, but it cost him there. McClung has it in the paint. misses the first. Both teams are making substitutions. Good on number two. Number 30 inbounds the ball. The Stags need to find some answers here. Top of the key. Good from three-point range. But they're still down by 15. Hooked away. And it's scooped up by Zero. Goes up. Gets the finger roll to fall. He's 2 for 2 for the game. McClung passes it up court. Crosses it over. Walker passes down low. Takes it up. Got the whistle, and he'll shoot a pair of free throws. And he makes the first. The Stags are going to make some substitutions. He gets them both. Kavaliauskas will come off the floor. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Right around 4 minutes left in the second half. Crew gets it. Right wing. Number 14 puts it up. No good from three-point land. He'll make that one most of the time.
Well, the D got a break on that one.
McClung shoots, gets the 3 to 4. They extend it to an 18-point lead.
Listen to the crowd burn. This kind of excitement is why I love college basketball.
From long range, corralled by number 15.
The defense was up to the challenge on that shot. Good job closing on the shooter.
Cross court. McClung shoots it. Can't hit from beyond the arc. But they still lead by 18. Zero. Takes it up. Brought in by number 15.
Don't put anything weak up like that.
I'm sure his coach will be telling him that. That last basket was nailed by McClung. 2:48 left in the game.
The D took too much time to set up, and it sure cost them.
Number 4 goes to the crossover. Passes it to the wing. Crew catches it. Right wing. That last tray, no good.
The defense was up to the challenge on that shot. Good job closing on the shooter.
McClung goes up. Fouled hard, and he'll take a trip to the line.
Shooting two.
Makes the first. Both teams are making substitutions. Gets the second to fall as well. Both teams will make some substitutions. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Feeds outside. Connects. He's got 12. Mosley tosses it up court. Number 5 shoots a 3. Got into the paint, and it's yanked down by number 20. Walker goes up. Crew grabs the rebound inside. The Stags have got a lot of ground to make up. Has it. Right wing. Let's take a look at the State Farm drive of the game.
He won't be denied, Vern. He just keeps coming at you in a multitude of ways.
Number 20 inbounds the ball. Nice little crossover. Left wing. Tosses it up. The three was off target by Mosley. They still have a 17-point lead. Number 14. It's blocked. Number 14 grabbed the rebound and whips it ahead. Last play off the mark by Cruz. Blocks that, and the rebound corralled by number 20.
The D served it up to him, and he still doesn't sink it. That'll give the coach a pain in the stomach.
Mosley with the crossover. Walker fires the three. Morning yanks down the offensive rebound.
His eyes lit up when he saw that shot go up. I love when guys get that excited about defense.
Beyond the arc. The offensive rebound pulled down by Cruz. That last 14-footer was no good. Mosley fires it way up court. Dumps it to the paint. Number 5 has it outside. Taken away by Zero.
They're going to need a miracle, Vern. Maybe even two.
Let's it go. Can't get it to fall from downtown.
That's another rebound for a team that's doing a great job on the boards. They've got a big edge there today.
Number 5 with the floater. Graceful finish.
They should hold on to the lead, Vern. If they play smart, they can walk away with the win.
Zero throws it up. Zero. Gets the long-range shot to fall. Morning inbounds the ball. Mosley takes it up. He grabs the rebound. It's deflected. And it's picked up by Georgetown. Poked loose. That'll do it. Georgetown beats the Stags 79-63.
There you have it. Let's see Georgetown Hoyas able to pick out their second win of the season. We came in at 2-3. We're now 2. We came in at 1-3. Now we are 2-3. We beat a small team, but sometimes that's the team that you need to beat to gain some confidence going into the conference games. As you see, Mac McClung had a career high of 30 points. He was really our leader today. He's the reason why we won. Jesse Govan had himself a big game.
Thanks, Vern.
He had 20 rebounds, completely manhandling.
I'm Greg Gumbel with today's version of the Pontiac
opposing big men. They were just completely undersized.
Momentum swing was a considerable
it was a big win
for us. This contest, the Georgetown Hawks.
Glad you enjoyed
you,
it.
This is Vern
stay tuned for some
Tracy
more
Wilson
videos. Like, comment,
we
subscribe.
Hope you this
let me know what you think
Oops.
About this legacy, this Georgetown Hoyas legacy mode. Until next time, I'm out.